The thing is with Brutus, if you can still be yourself or something in the band, or at least I have the feeling I like heavy bass and aggressive bass, and I can put that in. And after feeling that Stan, the music he likes, he can bring that in. And Stefanie, the notes she likes the most in music, she can bring that in. And that, for me, that's important for being in a band, because it's not always like that. With us, everybody can contribute and everybody is like equal, and everybody can discuss other people's parts, and like Stan has as much to say about the bass as Stefanie about the guitar, and change notes and critic on each other, and it's all the time like that. Every instrument is from everybody.
It was always worth the work. Yeah. Being in a room for 10 hours and trying to make something, it's difficult, I think, for most people. But at the end of the day, if you have 2 minutes of music that the three of you are like, I can't believe we made this, then it's done. That's all I need, yeah?
That and having fun.
Yes.
Once more we sing along to this never ending song. Once more we'll carry on to clean what if we thank you.
We all know each other from different projects from before. I used to be in a band with Stephanie. Stephanie used to be in a band with Peter. And I think the moment you two were in a band, you guys decided you wanted to start something.
Yeah, but
I think
it goes way back when Stan was 15 and I was 14.
Yes.
And then we were in a band back then, and we always like talked about starting a band of our own one day because we played music that other people wrote.
Yeah, it wasn't really our thing, yeah.
So yeah, I think the first idea of Brutus, if you can put it like that, was 2003.
Something like that, yeah.
And then in 2013, it actually started.
We rewrite music now. Anything can happen. And I know that in advance, that whatever way we choose to go, and like music-wise, it's always going to be something different. That's something that I feel more now than when I was younger, yeah. When we write songs, it's always with the three of us, so it's not me saying, like, I want to play this stuff and we have to work around it. It just happens, and if somebody plays something and all three of us feel it at the time we're writing a song, it stays in, whatever it is.
For me, I learned to be more open. Stan and Peter taught me, like, in the beginning, when they said, they gave suggestions, I was like, no. I only had yes or no, and now I'm older, so I can say no, but, or no, because, and before I didn't have the second part of the sentence. Like, it was just, can you try this? No. Why not? Because I don't want to. Or I know
good
it
times.
Will sound bad. And that was the first two records. Because, to be honest, I was very young. I was 22. I don't know what you were doing when you were 22. But if somebody told you, do this, you're like, why? For example, when somebody doesn't like a vocal note, I'm like, I'm going to cry myself to sleep. It's not good enough. And now it's just understanding that they have like helicopter perspective, and I'm like sometimes so in my head. So I just listen more now. I don't like ego. I think when somebody talks with ego, I'm already not listening. Like when it's about me, and not about the notes. So for me, because I don't like when ego takes over from instinct, because I can only tell for myself no is because my stomach hurts. Not no because I really want to play this part, or did you know I had 3 hours writing this part and now you're saying no? I will never say no when I don't mean it, because then you're just stupid.
I also think that, correct me if I'm wrong, Stan, the person with the less ego I know in my life is Stephanie. That's with true. All the talent she has and all the things she does and all the things she can do, it's always this that's speaking, and never I want to be this, or it's never I want to shine, or never, it's like always gut feeling, and she has absolutely no, in my opinion as a friend, it's absolutely no, zero
the
ego.
The less spotlight, the better.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, the light plan is also like when we make a record and then our light guy's coming, and then every record again are like, no front lights. Like, but it's a running joke now. So
we'll be right back.
song is about getting older, do it together, and going down together. But it's okay. We already tried to put Victoria on the record 3 times, so we already have it since birth. And it was never right. Like, I always felt like the vocal line didn't do justice to the guitar riff. I can say that because I didn't write the riff. I really liked the riff. And then now I think we were mature enough because it always had this, for me, nostalgic vibe. I think we weren't ready for it. Like the first record, it's so all over the place, which was the record we had to write at that time. After writing already a couple like typical Brutus songs, I think we were ready to make a rock song that we could make our parents proud, if you can put it like that. And then it wasn't until 1 month before the studio we had a different chorus. But we always liked the verses, and then I was like, there's something wrong with the chorus. And then I tried to sing Sweetness from Jimmy Drolled. I always do that, like, if that sounds better, it's not good what we have, because that's the best
that's
chorus.
It's the bar.
Yeah, or Sorrow from
Bad Religion.
Those are the two references. Like, if that sounds better, we have to change what we have. And it was like that already. Yeah. And then we wrote a new vocal lyric, and then it was ready, and it finally clicked.
I trust them, like their taste in music as well. So at the end of the day, for me personally, if I play a guitar lick and I'm like, oh yeah, look what I'm doing, and they're like, nah, then you know it's probably not gonna be good enough. So that's something I always look for.
One of the tactics is always changing what you like. Stan writes a riff and comes to us with the riff, or to Stefanie mostly, and then change the riff totally. Like replace a note. Okay, Stan, the fourth note, can you play it on the fifth and then pick the sixth and make it second? Yeah.
I think somebody just said, can you play it backwards just to see what it does? Stuff like that, or I'm tuning my guitar, I like that.
But
the stuff like that, it's like, yeah.
When Stan writes a riff and you're a guitarist, you can take all these jumps. I don't always think about certain jumps, so sometimes we're like, oh, maybe I should sing the riff that Stan wrote, because I wouldn't do that at all. And that's what I like about this band. For myself, if I can't see us playing that live, I know it will fail, or we will not play it live.
And that's also technical, with like, we were just three people, but we always try to sound, when we want to sound big as possible. And if we can't do it live, like with one, sometimes Stan sounds like, for me, like two guitars play, but it's just one guitar player.
Yeah, we have cool fans, but they're also very different. Like, it's not one specific type of person. It can be like the extreme metalhead, and we're like, how do you call it in English?
I know what you're trying to say. It's like
it's like peanut butter cups. Like, I can't eat this, but I really want to. And you see some crucial metalheads are like, this is guilty pleasure. Like, it's not really metal, but I kind of like it. So that's a type of person, but also the 16-year-old girl.
And the dads of the very young girls who bring their daughters of 11 to our shows.
Yeah. And who used to play in hardcore bands or something.
Yeah, like old punkers who now have, or hardcore guys who have now like young daughters who come to our shows. The hour on stage makes up for everything else. It's like the hours in the van, the hours behind the computer, the emails, the social media, everything that's coming with the band. It's like that hour on stage, when I'm there, it gives me all the energy to do all the rest.
For me, it was one of the coolest moments in this writing process when we wrote Brave.
It's actually the one I liked the least.
Yes, I was like, what is this song?
This is just basic. I don't really like this song. Now it's my favorite one to play live.
The music was so serious, and the lyrics had to do something else, I guess. Like, it is about brave, but more like, haha, you're so brave, as in, nah-uh. It was a first timer for a lot of things.
So then the title fits it perfectly, I guess, no?
Then the first album, we just played and we tried to make something with what we played. And the second album, I remember us saying in interviews, like, this album we talked more than the album before. Yeah. If we're together for 8 hours, we talk for 7 hours and play 1 hour of music. But that music is like better than just start to play music together. And I think with the third album, or now where we are now, that even without talking, we know what we like from each other. And that's a very comfortable feeling. But the process to get here was not easy, and it was long. And yes, we had fights, discussions. And yes, we had like difficult moments, but I want to play with them. And that's that core idea of like playing music with each other. It sounds very corny, but for me, it still stands above all the rest that is happening and it's coming to the band. And things that happen and stuff. It's like always the three of us making music, yes.